Good afternoon, everybody. Cam Biker here. It's a lunchtime ride, but it's not a lunch break. I'm on holiday. Hooray! Special holiday for my birthday. I'm old. Oh dear. The numbers increased. Everybody comes around and same old. Does it feel any different being a year older? Oh yes. My leg fell off this morning. And I've developed a rickets. I'm really old. I'm 21 again. As I got a friend of mine put in the birthday card. 21 again, literally. It's now 21 years since I was 21. The ripe old age of 42. I shall be drawing my pension soon. 42 is the meaning of life. What do you get when you multiply 6 by 9? Some people, they're mathematically gifted, but those who don't read Douglas Adams will be thinking he's got that wrong. Mrs. C pointed me at a news article yesterday. Oh, I say news, it was in the Daily Mail, so technically it's fear-mongering based on a snippet of information. But it was in the Daily Mail and it wasn't about immigration, so it was slightly different to the usual. And apparently, according to this, I say I don't know how truthful it is, but apparently the government is trialling changes to the driving test. Now, we all know how they keep faffing about with the motorbike test and how that's getting, well, I don't know about harder, but more long and drawn out and fiddly and faffing about with multiple tests at different ages and all this kind of stuff. I think if you get to be able to ride everything, you know, you do a CBT followed by a theory test and two tests, then another two tests to get on a bigger bike, and then another two tests to get a big bike if you actually follow it through from kind of 16 to ride the biggest thing that you're legally able to ride up until 21 or 24 or whatever it is. More long and drawn out. Well, apparently they're going to be making the driving test easier. I have no idea why, but I thought it was quite amusing. What they're talking about doing, they're saying they want to make it more realistic. So they're talking about doing away with two manoeuvres, those being reversing around a corner, because obviously in the real world you'll never do that. Heaven forbid you want to reverse into a side street and then drive back the other way to turn around. But they also want to get rid of the... I think they now call it the turn in the road using forward and reverse gears. As old 42-year-olds know it, the three-point turn. Where, you know, you're just on a standard road and you want to turn around. So they want to do away with those and they want to get instead... and potentially change, I should say, I didn't know it was in there, but same as on the motorbike test, so I guess makes sense. The independent driving section where they say to you, we want you to go to a certain place and you have to follow some signs for 5-10 minutes. Well, they want to modify that bit, so instead of the independent driving be you following signs, they'll set up a sat-nav and you have to follow the sat-nav. Presumably you have to be of an ability where you're not like these weird people who follow the sat-nav slightly incorrectly and end up driving into a river because they're too busy staring at the screen, presumably, and not out of the windows. Or maybe they just trust the sat-nav so much. Well, it looks like a river, but the sat-nav says this is the right way, so I'm going to plough on regardless. So apparently they're going to bring in GPS driving and remove the turnaround in the road and the reversing into a side street. And then they also want to add some parking, extra parking or something. Now, obviously, the immediate reaction to this is the Daily Mail reaction of, my God, this is the end of the world! I have to admit, I even went, what? This is a joke, isn't it? Is it April? Is it April Fools? But apparently it's somewhat true. Creeper. Apparently it's somewhat true. But yeah, presumably we're going to be able to set up services. All those older ones who've already got licenses and have learned how to turn around, we can all set up services. So anybody who lives in a cul-de-sac or a dead-end road, or anybody who accidentally turns into a dead-end road because they followed the GPS incorrectly, we'll be able to set up a service. We'll be, you know, the AA call themselves the fourth emergency service, which is handily forgetting about the Coast Guard. So really the AA should be at best the fifth. So us motor vloggers who can drive can get together. We can be the sixth emergency service. So we can set up a number. People can call us when they've gone down a dead end by accident. We can turn up on our motorbikes, park up, turn around, charge them 10 quid right away. How cool would that be, seeing as nobody's going to learn how to turn around anymore? What a service we can provide. Anyway, it leads me to a question for you all. Here's my question of the day, and I've probably asked this one before. But if you were going to be able to take out a manoeuvre and replace it with another bit of driving test, what would you go with? Motorbike awareness would be nice. Using your mirrors. Shoulder checks in cars, something like that. I think they're already supposed to be in there. What would you replace it with? What is a more modern thing? And I'm not talking sensible ones here, because the government clearly isn't. So what would be your new manoeuvre to make driving more up to date? If that car's going to fit in that little bit of parking space, I will be amazed. So I think if we're going to have more modern things, if we've got to, you know, clearly people are struggling with the test as is, and we've got to move it on to something that's more realistic for modern life, my suggestion would be, and this is before anybody has got me, this is facetious. I did a facetious one the other day and I had a few people put some negative comments on it, missing the point that it was a joke. I mean, clearly the one that the elephant in the room, the elephant in the car, was it Alpha Rider who did the bad joke challenge? If it was, here's my one. How do you get four elephants in a mini? Two in the front, two in the back. Boom, boom. Yeah, the elephant in the room, thanks for that, is far too hard to talk on your phone, text, and update your Facebook status whilst you're driving. So I think we need to have a section on tablet computing in the car. You have to send a text message, ring your mum, or parent or guardian, obviously, or nearest and dearest, doesn't have to be your mum. So send a text message, ring your mum, and update your Facebook status to say that you've sent a text message and rang your mum, all whilst driving. It'd be a minor if you scratch the car, and a major if you caused a dent. How about that? So there's my update. My idea. Let's know yours in the comments. The stupider the better. Our prize for the best one will be a mention in a video at some point, because, you know, it's Christmas coming up, I'm skin. Ooh, Southern Fried Tom, look at that. I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Right, that's enough waffle from me. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thank you for watching this old fart on a motorbike. See what I did there, Jim? Ride safe, everyone. And I'll talk to you all again soon. I'm a little teapot, short and stout.